So as our Han Da-eun just reported, Korea's next-generation fighter jet project has been sent back to square one earlier this afternoon.
Boeing's F-15 Silent Eagle had been the sole candidate to become Korea's next generation of fighter jet, but Lockheed Martin's F-35 and the EADS Eurofighter looks to be on the list again now.
Right, we have Arirang News Kim Hyun-bin standing by at the news center to give us the details on the surprising announcement and its implications. Good evening to you, Hyun-bin.
Hey, guys.
So now, since the other two fighter jets are back in the running, Hyun-bin, can you tell us what each of them bring to the table?
Well, there are pros and cons for each fighter jet. The F-35 is the only jet that has full stealth capabilities among the three. The F-15SC fits in the budget set by the Defense Acquisition Program Administration, while the Eurofighter promised to jointly manufacture most of its jets in Korea. The F-15SC is an upgraded version of the F-15K, which the Korean Air Force currently uses, so it fits in well with the Korea-U.S. Combined Forces strategy, and its airstrike capabilities have been proven on the battlefield. The F-15SC is also considered to have semi-stealth capabilities, but the level of those capabilities has yet to be determined, so there is an unknown there. The EADS Eurofighter has also semi-stealth capabilities, but at a little lower level than the F-15SC. EADS sweetened the deal by promising to invest $2 billion in technology transfer in Korea, and out of the 60 fighter jets that will be manufactured, 53 will be made in Korea, which will create more than 50,000 jobs here in the nation.
Now, Hyun-bin, you mentioned the stealth capabilities. Now, why is it so important for South Korean military to have this stealth-capable fighter jets? For those of us without an in-depth knowledge in aeronautics, what exactly does a stealth capability mean?
Well, fighter jets containing full stealth capabilities are better able to dodge radar detection. Take, for example, Lockheed Martin's F-35 in comparison to the F-15. The F-35, which has full stealth, looks 1/100th the size of the F-15 on radar, which of course makes it much harder to detect. And stealth can be used for other purposes as well.
Because stealth is the core technology, core capability we can use as an, you know, security strategy to not only just for the North Korean air power, for the neighboring countries' new developments. Chinese and Russians has developing their indigenous, you know, stealth fighter jets, and even neighboring Japan has made a contract with the F-35. So the F-35.
It's for this reason that F-15 retired Air Force Chief of Staff sent letters late August to the National Assembly, the Presidential Office, and the Defense Ministry to suggest a reconsideration of the selection criteria, which they felt was too weighted toward price over defense capability. The retired general stressed that out of the three choices, Lockheed Martin's F-35 is a more suitable choice due to its full stealth. With the project now up for grabs, what's now left for the Korean government to do? The South Korean government will go back and look further into the three candidates, try to reduce the asking price and find ways to add features. But experts say the most important thing is to ensure transfer of technology so Seoul is able to produce state-of-the-art fighter jets out of its own in the future. Even though Boeing promised to transfer technology in the first phase of the fighter jet project, not much information has been transferred.
We cannot depend upon the United States air technology forever. So we need some certain level of technology transfer. The South Korean air industry is not fully satisfied the level of technology transfer by the Boeing. So I think there is a lot of room to be should be improved in terms of technology.
The Korean government is currently preparing to launch its fighter jet development project, KFX, whose mission will be to produce advanced multi-role fighter jets. To do so, experts say that the Korean government needs to put more pressure on the three firms to ensure it gets the tech transfer the Korea needs.
Okay, Kim Hyun-bin, thank you for reporting on that. That was our Kim Hyun-bin reporting live on the fighter jet procurement project going all the way back to square one.